Men of Galilee, why gaze in wonder at the heavens? This Jesus whom you saw ascending into heaven will return as you saw him go. Alleluia. Let us praise God singing this morning. Hail the day that sees him rise.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. He presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, "Lord, are you at this time going to restore the king of Israel?" He answered them, "It is not for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has established by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth." When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, "Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. All you peoples, clap your hands, shout to God in gladness. The Lord we must fear, King of all the earth. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. God goes up to shouts of joy, sound the trumpet blast, sing praise to our God, praise unto our King. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. God is King of all the earth, sing with all your skill to the King of all nations, God enthroned on high. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call, what are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones, and what is the surprising greatness of his power for us to believe, in accord with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead and seating him at his right hand and in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet, and gave him as head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they saw him, they worshiped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
What does the Ascension mean? I mean, I know we're recounting that fact that Jesus ascended into heaven to be with the Father in the presence of others, but what does it mean to ascend? It means to become the best you can be, to elevate yourself to the highest possible level you can be. And we're not talking about an academic arena or in a work profession arena. We're talking about as person. To ascend to be the best possible version of myself. And in doing that, people will look at me with awe because I become that very gift that our God wants to give to the world. A gift of love, But when I am not the best version of me, I don't ascend. I'm humdrum. And sometimes I descend. I de-evolve. I become animal, arrogant, nasty, evil, all these wonderfully awesome things that so many people aspire to. But when I become the one who truly is a peacemaker, when I become the one who truly understands what it is to love, when I become the one who wants to forgive, when I become the one who wants to be helpful, oh, what a whip. What a pushover. And Jesus says, no. I send you out to make disciples. I send you out to make followers. Yes, you baptize in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. But in doing that, you baptize them into this way of life, this way of being the best version of oneself. And that is not an easy thing to do. But knowing it's not easy, aren't things a little bit easier when we have people who will help us out, people who will go with us? Like, I don't know about you. I am not one of these people, now I do admire them to a degree, who can go on vacation by themselves. I can't do that. I have to have someone I can share the experience with. Anyone I come back to talk about. I'm not one of these people who go sit to the movie theaters by myself. I can sit at home, but not in the theater. It's an experience I gotta be able to talk about. I'm not one of these people who will go to a restaurant and dine alone. Because I'm not dining. I'm just like, can't get it down fast enough to get out because it's not as enjoyable. So we know that when we go through life with friends, a lover, with whomever, life is a little sweeter, a little nicer, a little bit better because we have somebody to share it with. And Jesus says, I will be with you always. So therefore, you will never have to be alone in your mission of proclaiming this good news to the world, in your mission of not only raising yourself, but of raising others. It requires something that we, over the age of 20, have been so easy to relegate to teenagers. And that's called peer pressure. And we tell them, don't give in to peer pressure. Adults do it all the time. You give in to peer pressure all the time. I'll tell you, priests give in to it. We have to go to a function. We call each other, are you going to wear your blacks or not? That's the shirt, the collar. Should I look like a priest or not look like a priest? Well, what do you care? Wear it or don't wear it. I want to know what everybody else is doing. I want to stand out. I don't want to be the crazy one. Well, we always give in to peer pressure. We might not think it, but we do. But what is the pressure God is asking us? Well, when we ascend, it's freedom. The notion of going up, flying, being free. Be free to love. Be free to be you. Be free to be the gift that God sent you into the world to be. If Jesus wasn't everybody's cup of tea, you should not expect to be everybody's cup of tea. But for the ones who you are, what an awesome cup of tea you are. But we have to be at home with ourselves. We have become the best version of ourselves. We have to be free to do that. That's not always easy. It means letting go of ego, letting go of others' criticism that we so happily own. We just have to let go of all those things that hold us down. The best way to understand it is assign weight, a pound, a half a pound, 10 pounds, whatever it is. Assign a weight to these negative things. And once you do that, I want you to pretend you're in 8 feet of water with these things wrapped around your neck. How long can you tread that water before they pull you down and drown you? You have to free yourself, take it off, let it go, to rise up, to live, to be the best version of you. God will be with us always. Jesus will never abandon us. We will always have a community of love around us. Just open our hearts, open our eyes to accept the beauty that is truly ours. In response to the word proclaimed, let us make a profession of our faith using the words of the baptismal creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Savior, the Lord Jesus, ascended into heaven and intercedes for us. With confidence we pray.
That the victory of Jesus Christ over evil will fill the church with a desire for holiness. That the compassion of Jesus Christ will fill the leaders of governments with his concern for others. That the presence of Jesus Christ will fill the suffering with his consolation and strength. That the gospel of Jesus Christ fill all of us with a zeal for discipleship. That the grace of Jesus Christ will fill our lives with the knowledge and love of God.
Holy
that the mercy of Jesus Christ will fill those who have died with eternal glory, especially for our recently deceased. May they share in the everlasting union with Christ, who is the way, the truth, and the life.
We go forth singing, go to the world.